The first known celebration of sports, the Olympics, were held at Olympia, a site in southern Greece in the summer of 776 BC. But unlike today's games, it was men only, and they did so naked, no kit. Fast forward nearly 3,000 years, and the sports engineering and technology required within different sports is now vast, with new technologies regularly introduced into the market designed to improve performance and reduce injury risks for athletes. However, some things have barely changed. The focus of this technology and engineering in most sports is still heavily designed around men. The Springer journal, Sports Engineering, recently published an article that discussed 10 questions from a diverse author group of researchers, staff, and players. The purpose? To highlight the sex-biased issues within football, steering research and industry to address them, as has been happening in the aeronautical and healthcare worlds. Women's football is experiencing accelerated growth, which in turn has led to demands for a change in the technology and engineering by both players and staff within the elite women's game. But very little is currently known about the technological needs of women's football. A recent review identified just 32 scientific articles on technology in women's football versus thousands in men's. With all of this in mind, researchers set out to highlight the small steps made to date and the huge strides still needed to level the playing field for women's sport. From football boots, shorts, sports bras, and inclusive kit design, to balls, playing surfaces, and tracking devices, the researchers have issued a call to action for more research to ensure that new technologies, equipment, and clothing are developed to meet the specific needs of the elite women's game and are based on sound evidence. FIFA has identified women's football as the single biggest opportunity for growth in the game. The sport is on an upward trajectory in terms of development and investment. The researchers acknowledge there is a positive shift towards female-specific products and technologies, but there's still a long way to go to ensure that elite women in sport get the same level of support and input as men. They hope that their paper will inspire a team effort between researchers, sporting bodies, manufacturers, and others to address the currently neglected requirements within the elite women's sporting world.